The Antonio Project presents LNG Part 3, Characteristic and Cryogenic Material.
Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. In continue part 2 about liquefaction and properties of LNG, following is part 3 about characteristic and cryogenic material. In this animation video, I will share to you about natural gas molecular movement, flammability limit, and simulation for testing of cryogenic material. I do hope that you will enjoy the video and give you additional information about LNG. So, let's start the video.
Molecular motion. Molecular motion is the movement of molecules inside a substance without any external influence. The movement is randomly causing molecular collision, and this collision causes the bunching of molecules. In the kinetic theory of gases, increasing the temperature of a gas increases in average kinetic energy of the molecules, causing increased motion. In gaseous state, molecules are far apart and rapid random motion, occupying full volume of container. Molecular motion from gas to liquid state. This is the animation showing the molecules' motion during liquefaction. When the temperature decreased, the distance between molecules also decreased and condensed. The temperature then will change the form of molecules from gas form to liquid form. In the kinetic theory of gases, decreasing the temperature of a gas decreases in average kinetic energy of the molecules, causing decrease in motion. This decreased motion decreases the atmospheric pressure of the gas. When the temperature decreases, molecules will condense into mass of finite volume but variable shape, with smaller amplitude molecular motion. In liquid state, molecules are quite close together and move random motion throughout the container. Molecules move rapidly in all directions but collide with each other more frequently than in gases due to shorter distance between molecules. Volumetric transformation from gas form to liquid form. The Earth has enormous quantities of natural gas, but much of it is in areas far from where the gas is needed. To move this cleaner burning fuel across oceans, natural gas must be converted into liquefied natural gas, or LNG, with a process called liquefaction. Liquefied natural gas, or LNG, is the liquid form of natural gas at cryogenic temperature of minus 265 Fahrenheit or minus 162 degrees Celsius. When natural gas is turned into LNG, its volume shrinks by a factor of approximately 600. The cost of delivering large quantity of gas by pipeline rise rapidly with distance. This reduction in volume enables the gas to be transported economically over long distances. As you can see in the simulation, 600 cubes represent natural gas in gas states. The volume shrunk to 1 cube under liquid state. For example, 1 cubic meter of LNG will produce 600 cubic meter of natural gas at gas form in ambient temperature. With volume reduction in liquid state, natural gas volume reduced to 1 by 600. In this simulation showing, the cube represent LNG is being transported using ground vehicles and vessels. It's showing that by its volume 1 by 600 compared in gas states, LNG is able to be transported economically and safely. Meanwhile, in this simulation, when 2 cubes of LNG and converted to gas, the volume will increase to 600 times, meaning 2 times 600 cubes, equal to 1,200 cubes. To transport natural gas in this pipe, it will require more means of transportation, more times, and more workers involved. That is the reason is why natural gas being liquefied, changing it from a gas into a liquid that is 1/600 of its original volume. This dramatic reduction allow it to be shipped safely and efficiently aboard especially designed LNG vessels. LNG characteristic. Following is the LNG characteristic. LNG is colorless. It is clear. LNG has no odor. The odorant added to natural gas to give its characteristic. Odor are removed before liquefaction because they solidify at LNG temperature and disrupt the liquefaction process. LNG is non-toxic. LNG vapor may reduce the oxygen content in the vapor cloud. Breathing of cold vapor is a health hazard resulting in asphyxia. Over a short period of time, it will result in breathing discomfort. Prolonged breathing of cold vapors can lead to serious illness. LNG is non-corrosive substance. LNG will not damage or destroy other substances with which it comes into contact by means of a chemical reaction. LNG quickly vaporizes when spilled, forming a white cloud. This white cloud is condensed water vapor from humidity air surrounding the LNG surface, spillage, or container. At about -161 degrees Celsius or at the edge of the white cloud, the vapor becomes lighter than air and rapidly dissipates. LNG is a cryogenic liquid. Cryogenic liquids are generally considered those at temperature -75 degrees Celsius at atmospheric pressure. LNG or methane boils at approximately -162 degrees Celsius. The average auto-ignition temperature for pure methane at atmospheric pressure is 595 degrees Celsius. The auto-ignition temperature of LNG varies with composition. As the concentration of heavier hydrocarbon in LNG is increased, the auto-ignition temperature is lower. The flash point of a liquid is the lowest temperature at which that liquid will evolve sufficient vapor to form a flammable mixture with air. For LNG or methane, flash point is 175 degrees Celsius. Methane is not a significant air pollutant. Due to its insolubility, inactivity, and volatility, it is not considered a water pollutant. Flammability limit. Burning a fuel requires an ignition source and proper concentration of fuel and oxygen. Flammability limits expresses the amount of a fuel that must be present in air for the fuel to burn, assuming air contains 21% oxygen. Lower flammability limit or LFL is the lowest concentration of a combustible material in air that can produce a flash of fire or an explosion in the presence of an ignition source. Upper flammability limit or UFL, highest concentration or percentage of a gas or a vapor in air capable of producing a flash of fire in the presence of an ignition source, arch, or flame. Should liquefied gas be spilled in open space, the liquid will rapidly evaporate to produce a vapor cloud which will gradually disperse downwind. The vapor cloud or plume is flammable only over part of its area. This is the simulation of spilled LNG on deck. The vapor cloud is dispersed following the wind direction. The lower and upper flammability limits for methane in air are 5% and 15% by volume, respectively. In a closed tank, the percentage of methane nearly 100%, thus cannot ignite. Principally, methane leaking from a tank in a well-ventilated area is likely to rapidly dissipate to less than 5%. Because of this rapid dissipation, only a small area near the leak will have the proper concentration for ignition. On the diagram showing that in LNG spillage, the concentration of methane above 15%, the methane will not burn, through two concentration is to reach. Meanwhile, when the methane concentration is between 5% to 15%, methane capable to burn or flammable. Below 5% methane concentration will not burn due to too lean concentration of methane. LNG is a liquid that won't burn until it becomes a vapor, and the vapor won't burn until it mixes with air and become diluted to between 5% to 15%. Cryogenic material. The cryogenic pipelines have to withstand ultra-low temperature in LNG system. The pipe's material must be tough and strong enough in LNG temperature minus 162 degrees Celsius and not brittle. Following is the toughness test experiment for cryogenic material, and this is the tool used for testing toughness of steel pipe. The tool consists of a frame with hammer-type pendulum. The pendulum will be released from a set height. The energy developed by hammer-type pendulum will be absorbed by the tested steel pipe during impact occurred. First test is a standard carbon steel under ambient or room temperature. By releasing pendulum lock, the hammer-type pendulum will swing and hit the tested carbon steel pipe. The toughness describes the way the pipe reacts under sudden impacts. As you can see, the standard carbon steel under ambient temperature remains undamaged during toughness test. It's only partially dent on the impact place. Next experiment with two different types of pipes, standard carbon steel and stainless steel pipe, to find which material is suitable for cryogenic substance, especially LNG. For testing the toughness in cryogenic, both of pipes to be immersed into LNG, which is the cryogenic with temperature about minus 162 degrees Celsius. After about 20 seconds being soaked in the LNG, then place the free standard carbon steel into testing equipment properly. Next, release hammer-type pendulum block. Pendulum will swing and hit the free carbon steel. As you can see, due to failure to absorbing energy from hammer-type pendulum during impact, carbon steel pipe broken into pieces. At low temperature, the carbon steel is more brittle and impact toughness is low. Next is stainless steel pipe toughness test. After soaking the pipe inside of LNG, the free stainless steel pipe then placed on the toughness testing equipment. By releasing pendulum lock, the hammer pipe pendulum start to swinging to the stainless pipe, and an impact occur between pendulum and stainless steel pipe. This is the result of the impact. Deformation on the pipe is observed. The dent on the pipe surface due to the impact is not too bad, and physically there is no crack nor broken on the stainless steel pipe. The austenitic stainless steel such as 304 and 316 are, however, tough at cryogenic temperatures and can be classed as cryogenic steel. They can be considered suitable for sub-zero ambient temperature. The different properties of this material at low temperatures depend on various factors such as crystalline structure, grain size, the propensity to absorb contaminants from the atmosphere, heat treatments, etc.
I think that's all my explanation about LNG characteristic and testing of cryogenic material. If you have any question and advice, please write on the comment below. If you think that my video is useful, please click like and share button. Your simple contribution by subscribing my channel is highly appreciated. See you in my another video. Bye bye.
Thank you for watching my video. The Antonio Project.